Hello students, welcome back to one more session on environmental sciences, that is ecological pyramids. Ecological pyramids are nothing but graphical representation of feeding habits of different organisms in an ecosystem. So the diagram that shows relative amount of energy or organisms contained within each trophic level of a food chain is nothing but ecological pyramid. So in ecological pyramids, each and every part of a pyramid, for example, I have shown you on this one, each and every part of a pyramid, here it is plants, here is deer, later it is frogs, and then it is a lion. Each and every part of a pyramid represent to a trophic level. So there are trophic levels in a pyramid. The basal part of the pyramid is generally maximum number and is occupied by the producers, and the next trophic level is occupied by the primary consumers, and then secondary, and then to tertiary. Generally the apex is very less because the organisms that are nothing but predators which feed upon the other organisms for food are less in number in an ecosystem. So ecological pyramids were first studied by British ecologist Charles Elton in 1927. The first trophic level is producers, second trophic level is primary consumers, third are based on feeding habits of the different consumers or organisms. There are three types of ecological pyramids: pyramid of numbers, pyramid of biomass, and pyramid of energy. Pyramid of numbers speaks about the number of populations or number of organisms present in an ecosystem. It shows the relationship between successive trophic levels in terms of their number. Mostly, the pyramid of numbers is straight or upright, with number of individuals in successive higher trophic levels goes on decreasing from base to apex. I won't repeat again. Mostly, the pyramid of numbers is straight or upright, with number of individuals in successive higher trophic levels goes on decreasing from base to apex. So if you observe an ecosystem like grassland ecosystem, in a grassland ecosystem the producers nothing but grass or trees or anything, there are around, for example, there are around 20,000 in number. The primary consumers like grasshopper or rats, anything, they are in less number when compared to producers. So imagine there are around 5,000. And the secondary consumers, which depend upon primary consumers for food, there are around 2,000. If it is a grasshopper, you can imagine here a frog. If it is a rat, you can imagine here a snake, like that. And the tertiary consumers, when you come to the apex, there are only 100. Most probably it's not be 100, maybe in a two digit or in single digit also. Here, if there is a snake here in the secondary consumer, you can feel peacocks here. If there is a rabbit here as a secondary consumer, you can go for a lion, or if there is a rabbit, you can go for a fox, like that. So the number goes on decreasing when you see this pyramid of numbers. So if you observe like this, producers are more in number at the base, tertiary consumers, which are predators, which are very less in number. I have given one explanation for grass. Grasshopper is a herbivore, and this is a primary consumer. Snake is a secondary consumer, peacock is a tertiary consumer, which is a predator on snake. Always the ecosystem of numbers will be upright, only in exceptional cases. So this is about aquatic ecosystem. Here the phytoplankton, which are present in water, they are more in number when compared to the apex big fishes or cranes or tertiary predators or anything. So if you go up to the second level, these are zooplankton, which depend upon phytoplankton, and phytophagous organisms are also there. And if you go here, those fishes in the third trophic level, they depend upon the zooplankton also. And big small fishes are being eaten by the big fishes. This is how the number of fishes or the organisms in aquatic system goes on decreasing when compared to the phytoplankton. So this pyramid of numbers is just based on the number of organisms in it. A single plant may support the growth of many herbivores. A single plant may support the growth of many herbivores, and each herbivore in turn supports several parasites, and these parasites in turn support several hyperparasites. So from producers to the hyperparasites, the number will be increasing. So our pyramid is inverted in shape. Now the apex became the base, and the apex was converted to a base, and the base became the apex. So it is inverted. The number of organisms gradually shows an increase, making the pyramid inverted in shape. This is very clearly explained here in this slide. There is a single producer tree. Upon the producer, there are many mites, many insects or flies that depend upon this plant. And these insects are food for many birds. So this is how the birds are more in number, insects are also more in number, but the plant is single. So the single tree ecosystem is always inverted. There is an exceptional case there. We'll go for the second one, pyramid of biomass. The amount of organic matter present in the environment is called biomass. The amount of organic matter present in the environment is called biomass. The biomass is the total quantity or weight of organisms in a given area of volume. The biomass can also be total quantity or weight of organisms in a given area of volume. So in pyramid of biomass, the relationship between different trophic levels is mentioned in terms of weight of the organisms. Again, this is an approximation. We take a sample weight, but we don't go and weigh each and every organism present in the trophic level. So that is one of the limitation of the pyramid of biomass diagram, where there is inaccuracy in weighing the weight of the biomass. So biomass is a total quantity or weight of an organism in a given area of volume. The pyramid may be upright for grassland ecosystem, and it is inverted for pond ecosystem. Imagine this is a grassland ecosystem. The number of producers in the grassland will be more, so their dry weight per kg meter square will be more. In the picture, it is depicting as 809 kgs per meter square. And if you go for primary consumers, which are herbivores that depend upon producers for food, their dry weight has been reduced to 37 because their population is less when compared to producers. Their intake is also less when compared to producers. At the same time, if you go to secondary consumers, the dry weight has been decreased to 11, and for tertiary consumers, it is 1.5 kgs per meter square. Pyramid of biomass is usually determined by collecting all organisms occupying each trophic level separately and measuring their dry weight. Each trophic level has a certain mass of living material at a particular time called standing crop. Again, I repeat, each trophic level has a certain mass of living material at a particular time called standing crop. The standing crop is measured as a mass of living organisms or number in an unit area. So this is about terrestrial ecosystem, where the biomass of producers is more and the predators is less. I will show the aquatic ecosystem, where the biomass or producers in an aquatic region, that is phytoplankton, their dry weight is very less, 4 grams per meter cube. And as we go on to the top, the carnivores, the big fishes, their dry weight is more, that is 12 grams per meter cube. So this is how the pyramid of numbers of aquatic, pyramid of biomass of aquatic ecosystem is inverted because of less bioweight, less biomass of producers. So next one is pyramid of energy. The pyramid of energy is always upright. It is a overall flow of energy from one trophic level to another trophic level, where there is continuous loss of energy in the form of heat. This is measured in kilojoules or kilocalories per square meter. If we observe a grassland ecosystem, the producers capture a lot of energy from the sun, and they have a process of photosynthesis. They generate more food for themselves, they are self-nourishing. The herbivores consume food from producers, but because of many metabolic activities, some amount of energy is lost in the form of heat. Amount of energy is lost in the form of heat and also their metabolic activities. So because of this reason, the energy of herbivores is only 100 kilocalories per square meter. So energy is lost in the form of heat or any metabolic activity. So again we come to secondary consumers. Secondary consumers also energy is lost in the form of heat, and so it is only 50 kilocalories. Generally predators are less in number. These predators, they depend upon other organisms for food, that is they depend upon secondary consumers for food, and the energy that is transferred from secondary consumers to tertiary consumers is only 5 kilocalories per square meter. So this is how there is loss of energy continuously from one trophic level to other trophic level. The same thing has explained in the matter which is there here, and this is about pyramid of energy. If you go for the summary, we have pyramid of energy, which is always upright. Pyramid of numbers, this is also always upright except in single tree ecosystem. And pyramid of biomass, which is upright for grassland ecosystem and it is inverted for aquatic ecosystem. Thank you.